Toshiba gave all its attention to making business PCs, after getting out of the shrinking consumer PC market in 2016. If the company's premium Portage X20WD is an indication of where it's headed, the singular focus might pay off. The ultra-portable 2-in-1 starts at $999, AU$2,145 or £1,399 in the UK, and is available in several pre-assembled configurations. Or you can, at least in the US, configure one yourself to create a laptop like our review system, which hit $2,099. A better option, though, might be the similarly configured Signature Edition available through Microsoft for $1,500. Regardless of what processor, memory and storage you'd go with though, all the base features and components are the same and result in an excellent, if slightly buttoned up, tablet slash laptop hybrid. And while it's aimed at business users, students might want to consider it too. For its slim body and 2.4 pound weight, 1.1 kilograms, as well as the included Wacom powered TruePen active stylus, the screen doesn't separate from the keyboard like the Dell Latitude 12 5000 series 2-in-1s or the Microsoft Surface Pros, but instead folds back like on a Lenovo X1 Yoga. This style of 2-in-1 can be a little awkward to use in tablet mode, but that's not the case here thanks to its lightweight and not too big 12.5 inch 1920x1080 pixel display. Built with Gorilla Glass for extra durability, the screen has an anti-glare coating that actually works, and, combined with the 315-inch brightness, you won't struggle so much to see the screen outdoors. Doing more with less. Like all really compact and thin laptops, the Portage X20WD has a limited port assortment. In fact, it has just two, a standard USB 3.0 and a USB 3.1 Type-C with Thunderbolt 3. There is a headphone slash mic combo jack, but it has no direct video output, no Ethernet and no SD card slot. Making matters slightly worse is that the laptop charges through the Type-C port. That means you'll have to choose between power or using the port for something else. Luckily, Toshiba includes an HDMI to Type-C adapter with an additional Type-C port on it, so at least you have one out-of-the-box option for simultaneous video out and power. It's just that, if you want to go beyond that, say at an office desk, you'll have to invest in a dock of some sort, which,